Hi, everyone. My name is Leah Honor, and I'm here today with my colleague Tess Greinach, and we are your research data and scholarly communication librarians here at the Lamar Suter Library at UMass Chan Medical School. By the end of this session, you should be able to add and edit citations in your My Bibliography, understand the sections of the NSF biosketch, and build a primary NSF biosketch with SciENcv, either from scratch or by using an existing NIH biosketch as a template. But first, what is a biographical sketch? It's a specifically formatted resume required for all NSF applicants for research grants, and applicants are required to use the SciENcv tool. Using the short form for biosketch throughout this, we will be using the short form biosketch instead of biographical sketch throughout this presentation as well. Before we get into SciENcv itself, you will need to set up an NCBI account, and you can also link your ORCID account to your NCBI. Once you have completed this first step, we will be ready to be on our way. The second step of this process will be adding your publications, posters, and presentation information to your My Bibliography. Later, Tess will walk through the third step of how to input all of this information and these publications from My Bibliography or ORCID into your primary biographical sketch. Another source of information that SciENcv can pull from is ORCID. These are unique author identifiers that are now required by many journals and funders. Linking your ORCID account can be done from your NCBI dashboard under Account Settings and adding a new account. To add a delegate to your account, it will also be on the Account Settings page, and you have the option of providing access to your My Bibliography, SciENcv, or both. Once you have assigned a delegate, your delegate will receive an email that looks something like this. They will have to click on the link to confirm. You may be asking yourself, why is My Bibliography part of a class on biosketches and SciENcv? The reason is that one of the ways to add citations to your biosketch in SciENcv is through your My Bibliography. So how do you access your My Bibliography? Once you're logged into your NCBI account, if you're not brought there immediately, you can access your dashboard by clicking on the My NCBI in the top right corner. Or if you are one of the newly formatted NCBI sites like PubMed, click on your account name and then choose Dashboard from the drop-down menu. On the Dashboards page, click on the Manage by Bibliography link, which will appear in the left-hand column, or click on the Researcher's My Bibliography that you would like to manage. There's also a direct link in the newly formatted NCBI sites labeled Publications in the account dropdown. This will also bring you to your My Bibliography. When adding citations to My Bibliography, I always recommend pulling the article information from PubMed if it is available. If an article you need to add is not in PubMed, you can add it using an RIS file, which is a standard file from citation managers, any that you can export from, such as EndNote, Mendeley, or Zotero, a database such as Scopus, or you can choose to enter the information manually. All three of these options are available under the Add Citations drop-down menu. I find that I need to enter citations manually for most items that are not journal articles. So this is a great way to add any poster, conference presentation, dataset, or software information. If you're looking for a place to publish your poster, presentation slides, or datasets, we have an institutional repository called eScholarship at UMass Chan, where you can publish any work done here at UMass Chan Medical School and receive a DOI to be included in your CV or biosketch. These materials would also then be discoverable on Google Scholar. The SciENcv tool mirrors the structure of the biosketch. It helps to generate a compliant biosketch by adhering to the required formatting and also integrates with your My Bibliography and ORCID accounts. To access SciENcv, if you go back to the NCBI dashboard, the SciENcv box will be in the bottom right-hand corner. you can click on Manage SciENcv, which will bring you to the SciENcv tool. And once you've created your first biosketch, they will appear in a list like so. But let's go ahead and we will choose to create a new biosketch. Whenever you are creating a new biosketch, I always recommend pre-populating as much as possible. And that's why we recommend keeping a primary biosketch file that can act as a template. So you do not need to add your basic information such as publications or education or positions for each biosketch.
There are 5 sections to an NSF biographical sketch, starting with a section of identifying information, organizational affiliation, and location. Then Section A is professional preparation, post-secondary education, and training. Section B is appointments and positions. And Section C is where you're going to list up to 5 research products related to proposed projects and up to 5 other significant products. And these can be from My Bibliography or from ORCID. And we'll talk a little bit more about that. And Section D is the synergistic activities, where you can list up to 5 distinct examples of broader impact of professional and scholarly activity. These are usually shorter than the contributions to science section in an NIH biosketch. And finally, certification is required once the biosketch is complete. We're going to go into detail into each of these sections so you can start filling them out along the way. First up is the identifying information, organization, and location. To edit this, look for the edit link next to the section title. If you imported this information from an existing source, like an NIH biosketch or ORCID profile, and there's information missing, you'll see an error notice next to this section. So you'll make any edits necessary in this pop-up window. For Section A, you'll need to list in reverse chronological order all of your post-secondary training. Begin with the most recent professional education and include postdoctoral and fellowship training and baccalaureate and other initial professional education as applicable, listing each separately. And for each entry, you'll need to provide name and location of the institution, including country and state or province as applicable, degree received, a month and year of end date or expected end date, and field of study. And this information can be pulled from an existing data source if you link to it when you're creating your biosketch. And any missing information will be indicated with an error symbol that looks like an apostrophe, exclamation mark, sorry. If there is any training missing, you can add the professional preparation using the link at the top of the table. And then enter information required manually. Similarly, for Section B, list in reverse chronological order all professional positions and scientific appointments, both paid and unpaid, full-time and part-time, or voluntary or honorary. If you are short on space for professional appointments, you must only identify all current domestic and foreign professional appointments outside of your academic, professional, or institutional appointments at the proposing organization. Similar to Section A, this information may be imported from an outside data source. Just watch for missing information. So if any appointments or positions are missing, you can add them using the link at the top of the table. Looks like I need to update some of my past positions, actually. So I need, if you go to the next slide, you can see that I need to add the country and state for this position that was imported from an existing NIH biosketch. And if you're using an NIH biosketch today as your data source, all of your Section A and B locations probably need country and state added. An unfilled version of this window is also what will appear if you are manually entering a missing appointment or position. So for the products in Section C, you can list up to 10, with 5 being closely related to the proposed project, and up to 5 other significant products, whether or not they're related to the proposed project that demonstrates your qualifications to carry out the project as proposed. That's a lot of proposing. If you are short on space and have products with multiple authors, you can list the first couple of authors and then use et alia, or short form et al, in lieu of including the rest of the authors' names. But what counts as a research product? Most important criteria of a research product is that it must be citable and accessible. So it can't be a paper that's hiding under your bed. What the products can range from include publications, conference papers, and presentations, as we've mentioned already, but also other things like websites and other internet sites, technologies or techniques, inventions, patent applications, data, physical collections, audio and video, and software and models, as well as many other things like new business creation as well. So to add a product or edit an existing product, use the edit product links, or you can add citations from your My Bibliography or ORCID if you have it linked by clicking on the checkbox to the left of the desired citation and clicking continue. You can go to the next slide to show that. So you can see I've clicked on the links and then added them. And you can also reorder the products by dragging the citations as well, because you can have the citations in any order that you wish. And next slide. As I mentioned before, if you need space, so your biosketch meets the 3-page limit, you will need to add the citation to the My Bibliography manually and edit the author list there by deleting additional authors and adding an et al. Author is one option. If you add your citations through ORCID, you can edit the author list directly in SciENcv by going to the ORCID tab and clicking on the edit authors link next to the citation you want to edit the author's list for. When you're happy with the change, click Save. And the last section on the NSF biosketch is Section D, Synergistic Activities. In this section, you can list up to 5 distinct examples that demonstrate the broader impact of your professional and scholarly activities that focus on the integration and transfer of knowledge, as well as its creation. So some examples of this are innovations in teaching and training, development and refinements of research tools, development of databases, participating in international research collaborations. We've put a full list of some examples on the screen. What is not allowed is multiple examples to further describe a singular activity. So like a list of committees you're a member of or a list of prizes, basically try and avoid lists. The synergistic activities section is where you can use metrics to tell your story, such as citation counts and downloads. These can provide context and explanation to make metrics meaningful. What does that mean? If your work was mentioned in a policy, explain what the policy was for and describe how your work was discussed. For example, this work was described as a breakthrough study on ALS by a prominent researcher. You could also highlight comments from news stories, mentions in policies or patents, or once you're running your own lab, the work of students you have mentored. Writing your biosketch as a new researcher, here are some tips you should keep in mind. Consider your reviewer and avoid using excessive jargon and use a humble tone. Include only appropriate information. 2 or 3 solid synergistic activities are preferable to 5 sort of mediocre ones. And also consider all contributions you've made, such as your doctoral thesis or mentoring. And if you have no publications, describe your efforts on other people's papers and projects. I use this method. I conducted a literature review for this paper. I care for all the animals in this lab. In general, reviewers base their expectations for contributions on the seniority of the person filling out the biosketch. They're not going to expect the same number of contributions from a grad student who is new to their research topic and a full professor whose knowledge of a research topic has expanded to the point where crazy things happen. So some other general tips to keep in mind, always use first person. You could also use subheadings for each synergistic activity, or like a single word that sort of summarizes that activity to start off that your description. Clearly summarize your role in the synergistic activity and present your activities clearly and logically, whether it is career trajectory, chronologically, importance, relevance to the proposed research. And the same thing goes for your products as well. Because you have that option of how you want them to be ordered, think about what would be the best order. Maybe it's the relevance of the project or chronologically or importance. And also get input from mentors and colleagues who have been through this process before. They'll be able to give you some really great feedback. So how do you add a synergistic activity in SciENcv? So When you go down to section D, you will use that add synergistic activity link. You can also edit the order of your synergistic activities by using the up and down links on the right side of the title bar for each activity. The last step to finish off your biosketch is certification. The signature is the only part of the biosketch that cannot be delegated, and you will not be able to complete this step until all errors are addressed and all sections are complete. So if you're not seeing the download PDF button lit up in blue, check to make sure that you don't have any errors and all sections are filled. Once it is in blue, you will be able to export the biosketch as a PDF. Please do not convert it to Word. You will lose all the correct formatting and you will not meet the NSF requirements of being your biosketch being completed in SciENcv. And the PDF is what must be submitted with the application. You can save multiple biographical sketches within SciENcv. We recommend you keep a primary NSF biosketch to use as a basis for future NSF biosketches and create custom biosketches for each grant as needed. We provided a short checklist to make sure your biographical sketches are compliant for your information and a number of helpful links in the slides that are going to be shared from the proposal and award policies and procedures guide, an FAQ on using SciENcv, and some SciENcv help. The Center for Biomedical Career Development at UMass Chan is also a great resource if you would like feedback on your biosketch. To make an appointment, please contact Irina Parker. Thank you so much for listening to our presentation today. If you have any questions, do not hesitate to reach out to any of our team in the Research and Scholarly Communication Services. We'd be happy to help.